The London criminal is certainly a dull fellow. The thief or the murderer could roam London on a day like this, as the tiger does the jungle, unseen until he pounces, and then evident only to his victim. But this great and somber stage is set for something more worthy than that.
As far as I knew, the Count had gone and the museum was empty.
Count?
This may appeal to your lurid taste in fiction, Watson.
Some inquiry from us in a communication of even date concerning vampires.
Why 10 houses in such precise locations around London?
We seem to have been switched on to some Grimm's fairy tale.
The letters I request. Confusion.
It is a worthy setting if the devil did decide to dabble in the affairs of man.
It is a real crisis, Sherlock.
You listen. Let you know. What sweet music like. So you believe in that existence?
One doesn't have to believe in something to be frightened of. It's two different parts of the brain.
Do not let your eyes see nor your ears hear that which you cannot account for.
Quick! Let's get him out of here as fast as possible!
Some of these days you'll go too far. You and your friend will find yourself in trouble.
I condemn
Sherlock! Michael!
No more, I'm afraid. His life is over.
As deficient in human sympathy as he was preeminent in intelligence.
Returns from business abroad in Transylvania. Promptly suffers a complete mental breakdown.
Watson, you do know what Mycroft is.
I've seen him twice. In my graveyard.
What? You have set your creatures upon my track.
My creatures?
A troll eating the things of life like that, Lord of the Wolf. It appears best as vapor has fallen and vanished away.
I assure you now.
How an English gentleman. In such a manner that is beyond comprehension.
How could he ever guess his own brother would betray him?